But the answer is given in the form of RT naught, so we do not need to substitute the value of T naught, yes? So, in isothermal process, what we know? The work done. How can you determine the work done? From 3 to 1, what is the work done in this case? So, once we obtain the work done in this case, then what we will do? We will sum up all these 3, okay? And since in this case, P is constant, therefore, P equals, we can write P naught, okay? Because whatever P will remain at this point. Given 1 mole of an ideal monoatomic gas undergoes thermodynamic cycle from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 1. And the initial temperature of the gas is given as this much, okay? 300 Kelvin. And these are some data. And with all of this data, we have to evaluate the net work done by the cycle. Which one is the correct answer, okay? So, let me do one thing first. Let me just number this as A, B, and C, okay? So, first starting with A, we have 1 mole of an ideal monoatomic gas. It means N equals 1, okay? Because we need this formula PV equals NRT. But in this case, because N equals 1, we have the formula is PV equals RT, okay? This is a gas law, yes? So first, what we will do? We will first determine the work done in the process from 1 to 2. Let's mention this as W12. So we know that dW equals PdV, right? Therefore, the work done is dW equals integration of PdV, yes? From initial to final, okay? Let's rough work this as, okay? So that you should not get confused with the main work. So, if this is the work done from the process 1 to 2, we will apply this formula here, okay? We have this as integral VI VF P dV. Now, what is our VI? VI is V1, yes? And VF final point is 2. So, let's write this as V2 P dV. Now, what is V1? V1 is the initial, yes, the initial position. And at the initial position, V1 is V0 from here, V0. And V2 is the final position, that is here. And here we have V2 equals 3V0. Very simple, isn't it so? So, PdV. V0, 3V0, and we have our P equals given as alpha V, okay? Alpha V dV, alpha equals constant, V0, so it will come outside of the integral, 3V0, V dV. So integrating, what we obtain? V square by 2, V0, 3V0, yes? Simplifying, we will obtain from here 9V0 square minus by 2, 8. So, it will 4 alpha V0 square. So, we obtain the work done in this case W12 as 4 alpha V0 square. Now, we will apply this formula to convert this into the function of T, okay? Because we know the value of T, yes? So, if we substitute here PV, so we have P equals alpha V, right? I am doing the rough work here. Later I will erase it from here. So we have PV equals alpha V square, yes, from this data equals alpha V0 square actually. So alpha V0 square equals from here equals, since it is RT, RT0, therefore alpha V0 square equals RT0, yes? So what we are obtaining here, actually it will be 4 RT naught. Yes, 4 RT naught. We know the value of T naught. So, and R is constant. But the answer is given in the form of RT naught. So we do not need to substitute the value of T naught. Yes. Okay. So we have finished problem A. Now we will evaluate problem B. This is problem A part. Okay. So let's do problem B. What is the work done in this process from 2 to 3? Let's mention this as W23. Now observe that in this case we have PV equals constant. Yes. Now PV equals constant, what does it mean? It means it is an, yes, it is an isothermal process, right? Let me write this here. It is isothermal process. Yes. So in isothermal process, what we know? The work done. How can you determine the work done? In case of isothermal process, the work done is given by this formula. N RT ln. Did you remember what is ln? We have mentioned this in our calculus classes. Ln is log to the base E. Okay. Ln means log to the base E. Okay. So we have ln V 2 upon V1, but in this case we do not know V2, V1, so we will write this as, we will use the alternate formula, P1 by P2. Actually both are the formula actually. Let me just write it down here. The formula is this, NRT ln V2 upon V1 equals NRT. You can actually prove this. P1 upon P2. Okay, this is the formula. In this case, we do not know V2 right now. Okay, I mean in this case, actually it is V3. So we do not know V3. So we will write this in the form of pressure. Okay, P1 and P2. Let me just erase this. And let me just write this as, actually it is P3, okay, this one, it will be P3 and it will be P2, okay, because our process is from 2 to 3 and as I mentioned, we do not know V3 in this case, but we know P3, we know P2 from this data, okay, and N equals 1, so RT ln P2 is 3 P0 and P3 is P0, we obtain RT ln 3, okay, now we know R, we know ln 3, but what about T, how to determine T? Can you do it by yourself? Try it once yourself. Think for a few minutes. Pause the video. Think what will happen. Meanwhile, I am finishing this and you can check it whether you are correct or not. Okay. So basically, what is T is, since it is an isothermal process, so throughout this process from 2 to 3, T will remain constant. Isn't it so? In the isothermal process, T remains constant, right? So, T3 equals T2, okay? I mean, throughout this process, since T will remain constant, so we can say that T is basically T2 actually. Throughout this process, T equals T2. Whatever T is here, it will remain same throughout this process because T is constant. So what we are going to do, we will evaluate T2 first. And how we can determine T2? Well, it is also very simple. In order to determine T2, let me just erase this. What we will do, we will follow this gas law. We have to determine T2, that is temperature at this point. So we will again go to the fast process, that is from process 1 to process 2. So gas law, using gas law in this process from 1 to 2. So we have P1 V1 upon T1 equals P2 V2 upon T2, right? Implies T2, if we simplify this, P2 V2 upon P1 V1 times T1, okay? Now here T1 means this temperature at this point, which is already given. This is our initial temperature, T0. So we have, this implies T2 P2 V2 upon P1 V1 times T0, yes? Now, since we are in the process 1 to 2 and we know in this process the relation between P and V is P equals alpha V. So, what we are going to do, we will substitute the value P2 equals alpha V2 times V2, P1 is equal alpha V1 times V1 times T0. Alpha will get cancelled out, it is V2 square by V1 square T0, okay? We can write V2 V1 whole square T0, yes? Now, what is V2? That is, at this point we have V2 equals 3V0, correct? And at this point, that is V1, we have V0. So we will simply substitute the value V at this position, it is 3V0. If you have any doubt in understanding, do let me know in the comment section, okay? T0, V0 will get cancelled out, 3 square, 9, T0. So, we obtain our T2 equals 9, T0, yes? So, from here we can write, then we will just substitute the value here. W23 equals R T0. Sorry, 9 R T0 actually. 9 R T0 ln 3. 9. Now ln 3 value is given approximately 1.09 R T0. If we simplify this, we obtain 9.81 R T0. So the work done in this case we obtain is, let me just write it down here. In this case we obtain the work done W23 equals 9.81 R T0. Okay. Now we have determined the final one, the process from 3 to 1, what is the work done in this case. So once we obtain the work done in this case, then what we will do, we will sum up all these three, okay? This is the approach actually. Problem C. So let's mention this as W31. So you have to determine the work done in this case. Now we have P equals constant here, okay? So we know if P equals constant, in this case the formula for the work done is given by, observe that in all the cases we are just applying the formula, so you have to memorize the formula, okay? Only then you can easily solve this problem. There is not so difficult to solve this type of problem. You just have to remember the formula, that's all. I am not doing any tricks, or there is no, you do not have to be super intelligent to solve this problem. You just have to memorize the formula. That's all. It is very simple. So this is a formula in this case when P equals constant and Vf minus Vi, that is Vf. Now, in this case, we start from point 3 and we reach at point 1, okay? We reach to point 1. Therefore, our final position is 1 and initial position is 3. Therefore, it is V1 minus V3, okay? Now, what is V1? V1, mention here it is V0. V0, but we do not know V3, yes? We do not know what is V here, what is the value of V here, we do not know. We have to determine it, okay? We have to determine this quantity, okay? So, how we are going to do this? Well, it's pretty simple. We will just follow the earlier strategy as what we have done. We are unaware about T. So, in order to determine T, we move back to the process 1 to 2. Similarly, in this process, we do not know V3. Therefore, in order to determine what we will do, we will move back to 2 to 3 in this process. So, what is happening in the 2 to 3 process? What is happening in 2 to 3 process? In this case, we know that PV equals constant, right? Therefore, P3V3, right? So, from this equation, we can easily determine P3. It is P2V2 upon P3, right? So, what is P2 here? We have given P2. Just see. P2 is given as 3P0, right? From here. At this position, P2 is 3P0. And at this position, P3 is only P0, okay? And our V2, how much is our V2? V2 we have given here. V2 is 3V0, yes? So, simply substituting the value, see, we easily obtain it is 9V0. Did you understand why V2 is 3V0? Because it is given here. V2 equals 3V0. As what we have did in our earlier this problem, while solving this problem. So we have V3 equals 9V0. Okay. So we'll just substitute this value here. Substituting, we obtain V0, 9V0, that is 8PV0. Now we know PV equals RT. So, this is actually minus 8RT0, okay? And since in this case, T is constant, therefore, P equals, we can write P0, okay? Because whatever P will remain at this position, at the position 1, position number 1, will remain same throughout this process, okay? So, P3 equals P1 and we know P1 equals P0. P is constant. It is P0 given. So, we obtain W31. In this case, we obtain W31 as minus 8RT0. Okay. So, now what we are going to do, the net work done. We have to determine the net work done. So, how much is the net work done? It is W12, this one, plus W23, this one, plus W31, plus W31. Let's substitute the value and simplify it quickly. It is 4RT0 plus 9.81RT0 minus 8RT0, okay? So, if we simplify this, 4 minus 8 minus 4 and then 9.81 minus 4 RT0, which we obtain, I think, 5.81 R T naught. That is, I think, option D. Yes, option D is correct.